night's devotional. This is Apostle. I want to thank God for this day He has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. We are piercing darkness with the gospel. The gospel is going across the nation and across the world. Jesus is coming back soon. The Bible says the gospel shall preach as a witness and the end shall come. We are taking the gospel to the lost. I want to invite you to our One Night of Miracle Crusade coming up at the Prophet Center, June the 6th, 7 p.m. The glory of God is going to be present. Miracles are going to be happening. Jesus is going to be glorified. Bible said, nothing is impossible with the Lord. All things are possible with them that believe. Mark your calendar, June the 6th or 7 p.m. I look forward to see you there. All road leads to the Prophet Center for One Night of Miracles. I look forward to see you there, and God bless you.
Get ready, South Florida and West Palm Beach. One Night of Miracles is coming to the beautiful Raymond F. Kravis Center Performing Arts Theater with Apostle Ronald Solly and Power Evangelism Ministries. It is free admission and free parking. The address is 701 Okeechobee Boulevard in downtown West Palm Beach. For more information, visit our website, powerevangelism.net, or call us at 561-337-9018, 561-337-9018. It is free admission to attend. You don't want to miss this great opportunity, as God will be glorified. Miracles will happen, and the sick will be prayed for. Those oppressed will be set free, and Jesus is going to show up and do mighty things for His glory. Whatever situation, whatever problem, whatever adversity you're facing in your life, nothing is impossible with God. All things are possible to those who believe. And what better way to gather in the wonderful Dreyfus Hall at the wonderful, beautiful Kravis Center in downtown West Palm Beach, June the 6th at 7 p.m. Thank you again, and remember, we look forward to seeing you, your friends, and your family in this awesome event, life-changing for the glory of God. Your miracle is waiting for you, June the 6th, 2015, at 7 p.m. at the Raymond F. Kravis Center in downtown West Palm Beach with Power Evangelism Ministries and Apostle Ronald Solly. Visit our website for more information, powerevangelism.net.
Now, when sin came, it separated man from God. And Satan became the god of man because of sin. The Bible said the god of this world has blinded what? The eyes. Because once God rejects you, Satan takes over. The god with a small g. Not the creator, but the thief. He is the god of all the rebellious. I'm about to say something that's going to blow your mind. He's the God over all the religious. I told you I was going to shock you tonight. Because religion is a form of godliness, but it denies the power of God. Listen to this. Anything that is godly, but yet denies the truth, is not of God. And this is why you need to get your heart right, because Jesus is coming back soon. We go to church to seek God, but we don't stop seeking Him when the service ends. We got to seek Him on the road. We got to seek Him when we go shopping. We got to seek Him when you're fixing a house. We got to seek Him every day. Jesus is not an experience on Sunday morning. Jesus is what you need every day. You got to love Him, talk to Him every day. You don't only need Him when you go to church building. A time has come for you to go deeper. Forsake not fellowship. Fellowship, go to church, praise the Lord. But you have to have a deeper encounter with God. Because if the leader, if the church system, God never made denominations. That's the devil. Satan created, instituted denominations to fight the move of God. Where are they in the Bible? Where are the denominations in the Bible? That's the work of man. It's Satan wants to label and limit. You have to understand this, that the move of God can be put and limited denomination, because the denomination is going to try to put a limit to how far and what you can do. And I'm not against denominations, but I'm here to tell you, God never created denominations. It's not of God. It's godly, but it's not of God. Let me show you what is of God. True repentance, true prayer, true sacrifice, true holiness and salvation, which cometh when you receive Christ in your heart. And we got to be ready for the Master's return. Thank God for the denominations, the buildings. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Keep building those buildings. But I got some news for you. The harvest is coming in. He's going to break those boundaries. I want to preach in a church in Florida. And they said, we don't baptize in this church people until they attend 6 months of baptism school. I said, what? 6 months. He said, in our denomination, yes, 6 months. If they give that of Jesus, we don't baptize them until 6 months. And I said, I want to preach in a witchcraft stronghold in Africa called Sumbawanga. And people give their life to Jesus, and God told me, baptize them right away. I baptized them in that night. I preached them at from 4 to 7, and then we took them and baptized them in the church building. They had a baptism in the night. We had a baptism service every night. We had a baptism service. Don't tell me to wait for 6 months because God just took them out of the devil's hand. We have to break out of denominational lines and bring people into God's kingdom. Somebody say hallelujah. Glory to God. We got to break out of these barriers. We got to break out of these denominations. We got to break out of these religious facades and go after God with all our heart. It's okay to have an authority, a bishop, whatever it is, but we have to understand that God's going to break all those barriers because revival is coming. People want to see Jesus. Philosophies of men and Bible theologians and people decoding, coming up with these codes and decoding it, releasing movies from Hollywood, Da Vinci Code, talking about Jesus had this or blah, 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 blah. It's a plan of the enemy to distort Christ. Satan is working tirelessly to distort the message. To distort what? The message. He wants to distort the message. Be ready. Because if the neighbor next door comes and knocks on your door and says, pray for me, I just had a vision of hell. I don't want to go to hell. I know you go to church every day. I want to receive Jesus right there. Tell him, get on your knees and say after me, Lord Jesus, come into my heart, save me, remove my name from the book of death, write my name in the book of life. I accept in my heart as my Lord and Savior. I am born again. And pray for them and they're born again. Somebody say amen. If there's a pool right there by you, baptize them and dip them in the water. And so you baptize them of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. You are released now. You're a believer. Go in souls to Christ. Jesus is coming back soon. There's no time to waste. We're not going to wait for denominational conferences to authorize. You think about how many denominations now have authorized homosexual marriages. I'm not going to name names. They say it's okay. And I'm not going to name names because I don't want to do that. But you know, go do your own research. And they're twisting the scripture. And we can't, I want more than what they wrote about. You know, God told me when I was in Greenville, son, it's time for you to tell the people they got to believe God, me, God, for to do miracles that are bigger beyond that what even they saw in the Bible. Because this generation has gone wild. It's gone crazy. We got to have the kind of radical faith. I got faith to blow on a microphone and release an entire hospital. I could walk into Mayo Hospital and discharge all the sick patients out of that hospital and send doctors home broke. You say, what did you say? I got a kind of crazy faith. And I'm not just going to do things because I want to do them. But if God told me, son, go discharge them, I'll go discharge them. We got faith walk down into a deaf school and shut it down because everybody can hear. They don't need. You saw what happened yesterday. The kid came here. Over $1 million medical bills. Walked in here. God opened the ear instantly. No dime. Give them the best clap offering. Hallelujah. When Jesus comes, the tempter's power is broken. Give me Jesus. Don't give me a denomination. Give me Jesus. Don't give me religion. It's a form of godliness, but it denies the power of God. How dare preachers come and say, God doesn't do miracles today. Oh, it's false prophets that do miracles. No. People of God do bigger miracles, greater miracles. We don't care what the devil does because the devil is a copycat. When Moses put his shirt stick there, the stick of the magicians came there too and turned to a snake, but the Moses snake swallowed all the magicians. We ain't going to be scared of the supernatural because of some soothsayers and whatever out there, the stuff they do, the Kundalini. We don't care about Kundalini and all the ikankan, whatever stuff is going on, we know the power of God is more dynamis, more powerful, more stronger, more greater than any devil out of there. Somebody say hallelujah. I want Jesus. I want Jesus more than... Do you know who tried to stop Jesus? It was the Pharisees and the Sadducees. The religious folks that tried to stop him when he came. And that's the same demon that's trying to stop him today. It was the same demon that was manifesting through those Pharisees. They were questioning his authority. Questioning the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Questioning the manifestation of the Holy Spirit. Questioning the things that God does. It's the same devil. I want you to go past the ordinary. Somebody say, I want to go past the ordinary. Say, I want deeper, deeper affection. Listen to me. Most people, they have reduced the time they spend with God for worship. Do you know most services now, they're 45 minutes? Most churches, the service is 1 hour. And some of them, it's 45 minutes or to 30 minutes. Exactly. Three songs and then someone which is totally dead that even a cockroach won't clap its hand. You don't understand this, that that's what the devil wants to do. Multi-million dollar buildings and they can't even have a night prayer. You go to Africa, 70 million people gather in the night because no building can contain them. They have to go to a stadium and they pray all night from 5 to 5 in the morning. Worship and prayer. Packed out in stadium. Matter of fact, the place is not even a stadium. It's an open field. It's so big that when they make an altar call, buses have to drive people to the altar. God can do that in America. He could do that in America, but we got to break these religious boundaries. There's a lot of fancy buildings in Minnesota. The Holy Ghost doesn't even know the address. Of course, he knows everything, but the last time he was invited was many years ago when the building was just being built. We want God. This generation must see God. Thank God for those buildings, but it's time for the Holy Ghost to invade the parking lot so people can get drunk in the Holy Ghost and stay there for 3 weeks. Do you know one of the most dangerous weapons Satan uses is deception? Let me show how deception works. It twists the truth, like paints the lie. It tries to twist your perception of the truth, and it paints a lie with the color of truth. It's not real. That's why you have to test every spirit through the scripture. Test every spirit through what? Does God heal today? Of course he does. Before I finish, he came to his own, they perceived him not. Perception. I got to emphasize the word perception here. You got to protect your perception from today. Let me show something here. Don't listen to anybody that will come and tell you that there's another way that can lead to God, not Jesus only. Only Jesus is the way. There's no other way. Number two, anybody that comes to distort the revelation of Christ that God has given you, the things that you have discovered that God has taught you about God through the time. You've been through some trials. You've been through some tests. You've been through some ups and downs that nobody could go through. If people went through what you went through, they could have killed themselves a long time ago. But you're still standing. Why? Because Christ was with you, holding you, teaching you the lesson of life. You are not a fantasy believer. You are a real believer. You're not an emotional believer. You're a real believer. You're not a roller coaster believer. You're a real believer. You've been through some stuff. You came here tonight because you won some spiritual battles. The devil never wanted you to be here tonight. You made it here tonight because God wanted you to be here. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm a walking sign and wonder. I'm a walking miracle. The devil tried to kill you last year. He failed. You are still alive. I said the devil tried to kill you last year. He failed. You're still alive. All the problems you're facing, it is a message from Satan. Leave Jesus alone. Tell the devil, no, get my back, Satan. I ain't leaving him alone. I want him now. This is how you're going to deal with a mountain. God doesn't need your hands to remove a mountain. I know your hands are good and you can throw them, because if you're sleeping and somebody come and touch you in a way you don't like, you're going to throw your hand. It's a natural instinct to defend yourself. I saw a four-week-old baby, knew how to fold his fist. I said, who taught this baby how to fold a fist? Four-week-old baby. God doesn't need your hand when it comes to a mountain. He wants you to speak to a mountain. This is why the mountain has not gone, because you're trying to move it with your hands. Help! Help! It's not going to move. You go sing songs, you take breaks, call for backup. Let's go. Ooh. It will never move. But the moment you say, in the name of Jesus, I command you. Poof. Supernatural. It's going to take the supernatural hand of God to remove that mountain out of your life. Somebody say hallelujah. It will take the supernatural hand of God to take you out of debt. It will take the supernatural hand of God to remove that incurable sickness out of your life. It will take the supernatural hand of God to save your daughter, your son that is living in sin and in rebellion. You talk to them. You call every prayer line. You did everything you can do, and they're still not changing. Why? Because if they want to change now, you're going to take credit and say, it is me. I did it. I called so-and-so. God don't want none of that stuff. He wanted you to say, I gave up, but God never gave up. He showed up right on time. God may come not so early, but he'll be on time. He's never too early and he's never too late. But he's right on time. The moment it comes out of your hands, it becomes God's business. The moment you're holding into it, it's your business. He will never share his glory with any man. He will never. When I was praying for the girl's leg, after prayer for her, he told me, stand on the altar. So I stood on the altar. And I commanded the leg to come. It began to come. She didn't want to come on the altar for prayer. She was right there. The grandmother brought her to the altar. The woman you just saw there walk out of the wheelchair. The Lord just amazingly touched her, because he told me to command her to get up and start walking. She just got up. And before I even could tell her what God told me, she already had the same time I spoke it, she heard it. She took off the oxygen tank and began to walk. She could not take 5 steps without collapsing. She took more than 100 steps in front of her eyes. God inserted a new lung in her. That's the Jesus I'm talking about. He wants to move in your life. There are things in your life that are crazy, that if you begin to tell your life story, I mean, people are going to run away. Some stuff you're going through is insane that nobody can understand. They're going to think you lost your mind if you tell him your problem. But I got some news for you. Jesus knows what you're going through. And he wants you to speak to the mountain. When you speak to the mountain, you're quoting the scripture. You're standing on God's promise. Look at Jesus as the one, that only one that can deliver you and set you free. He wants you to trust him. We trust in insurances. We trust in government. We trust in welfare. We trust in what doctors say. We trust in what the bank say. The bank says you don't qualify to buy a home. Tell him, shut up and go to sleep. God says, I qualify. This is my business card. Call me if you need money. And walk out of the bank. Somebody say hallelujah. Never go shopping for a house. Look like you don't know what you're doing about it. Know what you want. Let me just say, your mansion is in heaven is so expensive that all the money in America couldn't even pay for one piece of the mansion in heaven. Did you hear that? Do you know I prayed for a man that was $1 million in debt? 1 week he was out of debt. Oh Lord. So it was after me. I love you, Jesus. Are you still here? Because I'm deep in the glory. Can I say a few more things? Are you ready for this? Please write this one down, because this is our last night. I gotta say this. I just need a few minutes to say this, because this is real deal. This shocked me the most. that he came to his own people and they perceived him not. Do you know that perception is the most powerful tool, powerful token, gift, ability is the word I was looking for. Perception is the most powerful ability you have given to you by God. You know why you're here? Because you perceive God is here. Not many people are here because they don't even know. They heard about it, but they don't perceive it. The stuff you heard today is earth shaking. There's a lot of angels here. If God could open your eyes, you'd be blown away. I can't talk like this if God's angels were not here. Take a look. God spoke to me and told me you're coming tonight and told me to talk about your testimony. Diagnosed with HIV. Left for dead. She came and said, man of God, pray for me. I said, yes. And I told her, God has healed you. She went for a test. She came back. Somebody say hallelujah. Say, yeah. The Lord flushed the virus out. The Lord gave her two beautiful children. They're very healthy and they're living for the Lord. She's standing here as a living testimony that the power
of God is going to stop the ringing in her ear right now. How many of you believe God is going to do it right now?
She had a ringing in her ear for over 1 year, Apostle. After you prayed for her, she said, no more ringing. It's all gone right now.
Turn around. Take the microphone.
God is a healer. Just yesterday, it sounded like a washing machine just going in my ear. I don't hear anything now. Hallelujah.
My ear had started ringing before I got to Augusta. I've been having problems for years with my ears ringing, and I would get off balance, but I thank God my ear done stopped ringing now. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to your name, God.
The Lord is restored to fix the bladder, and now he's walking on the bones for his glory. You're going to have to walk with her and put her on exercise. Let me show you what you're going to do. Hold this microphone, baby. Watch me.
Lord, I worship you.
Follow me.
Because of who you are.
Yes, just follow me. In the glory. Seven steps.
I worship you because of who you are. Because of who
take
you
them.
Are.
Look at it.
I give you glory.
Those are steps in the glory. You're going to live all the days of your life. You're going to live all the days of your life. Do that every day, and every day she's gonna get better and 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 better. Bring the thing.
Get ready, South Florida and West Palm Beach. One Night of Miracles is coming to the beautiful Raymond F. Kravis Center and Performing Arts Theater with Apostle Ronald Solly and Power Evangelism Ministries. It is free admission and free parking. The address is 701 Okeechobee Boulevard in downtown West Palm Beach. For more information, visit our website, powerevangelism.net, or call us at 561-337-9018, 561-337-9018. It is free admission to attend. You don't want to miss this great opportunity, as God will be glorified. Miracles will happen, and the sick will be prayed for. Those oppressed will be set free, and Jesus is going to show up and do mighty things for his glory. Whatever situation, whatever problem, whatever adversity you're facing in your life, nothing is impossible with God. All things are possible to those who believe. And what better way to gather in the wonderful Dreyfus Hall at the wonderful, beautiful Kravis Center in downtown West Palm Beach, June the 6th at 7 p.m. Thank you again, and remember, we look forward to seeing you, your friends, and your family in this awesome event, life-changing for the glory of God. Your miracle is waiting for you, June the 6th, 2015, at 7 p.m. at the Raymond F. Kravis Center in downtown West Palm Beach, with Power Evangelism Ministries and Apostle Ronald Solid. Visit our website for more information, powerevangelism.net.
I'm out of time, but before I go on and lead you to Christ, if you don't have Christ in your heart, simply say after me, Lord Jesus, come into my heart and save me. Remove my name from the book of death. Write my name in the book of life. I accept my heart as my Lord and Savior. I renounce my sin. I am born again. If you made a commitment to Christ, now you're born again. Stay in Christ and not backslide. Jesus is Lord. Read your Bible and pray every day. And we'll be back next week at the same time. Don't miss Youth Camp, July 30th through the 18th. And don't miss our special crusade, June the 6th. I love you all and God bless you.
See the clouds.